to describe it, but generally, in the last 5-6 years, Messi has been on the decline, and the statistics suggest so. I mean, if you're looking at Messi in the elite competition, that is the Champions League, he's been very much on the decline, and I think that it summarizes everything that has happened at PSG. You look at PSG, you look at Messi's stint with PSG, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'll give him 2.5 over 10. I think that Messi's one of the biggest mercenaries in football. He went there for the money. He did not go there to play football. And I'm pretty sure that for everybody who watched that game between PSG and Clermont yesterday, the reaction of the fans talked about everything that Lionel Messi has come to be defined with PSG. You look at everything that happened yesterday on the pitch. You look at him being booed. You look at the fact that wherever he had the ball at his feet, people had to boo him and all of that. I think that it's not been the best love story with PSG. I think that his stint with PSG has generally been very poor. You know, the truth of the matter is that he was signed by PSG to be one of the catalysts for them winning the Champions League. And ironically, he had been already on the decline before he joined PSG in the context of the Champions League. So nothing short of an anticlimax. I think that he went there for the money. He's made the money. They do not want to renew his contract. Life goes on. But
it's actually Messi who has actually declined a contract renewal for.
Well, PSG were never going to renew. That's the point. I don't know where you are getting your sources from. But the point of the matter is that it did not make footballing sense to keep Messi on their books. I mean, he was becoming fast a liability with all of the drama surrounding him, with all of the things that had gone on under the bridge, and some of the stories that have circled in and have come to the fore. I think that it was always going to be clear that PSG considered him a liability, did not want him on their books. Indeed, I mean, if you look at all of the things that PSG are doing postseason, Sergio Ramos has also been allowed to go. I think it's time that they focused on footballing, a proper footballing project. If they want to win the Champions League, if they want to make giant strides into the Champions League, they do not need to be dilly-dallying with some of these mercenaries. And for me, Lionel Messi is one of the biggest mercenaries football has seen. And rightly so, I am happy that PSG has finally wanted to see his back. I mean, but with the link to Barcelona, I mean, there's a lot of money flying around in football right now. I was reading that Al Ittihad want to offer Karim Benzema 400 million euros for 2 years, same as Al Nassr offered Cristiano Ronaldo. And so there's a lot of money. If you look at now, I'm hearing that there are delegates from Saudi Arabia flying in into London to try to lure Kante to the Saudi Arabian League.
Yeah, we'll talk about Karim Benzema and, you know, his time.
No, this is just to zoom in on the monies that is being purported, because there's an interest from David Beckham's Inter Miami, you understand? And there's a lot of money, there's a lucrative contract, supposedly. And obviously, you would want to look at all of the fine details of these pensioners and the monies being bundled around some of these pensioners: Karim Benzema, Cristiano Ronaldo, Lionel Messi, probably Luka Modric. The last of the golden generation, I should put it that way. But let me touch quickly on the Barcelona stint. I mean, truth of the matter is that who are Barcelona trying to fool? They are broke. They cannot afford Messi. I don't know why they want to go on this charm offensive. Barcelona does not have the money to support any coming back of Messi. End of story. I mean, all of this drama, all of this sensationalism, Messi coming back to Barcelona, cuts the crap. They do not have that money. to be dancing around with Lionel Messi is not coming to play for free. Already, you are fighting a huge wage bill. And for me, you see, I want to sound very diplomatic on this show because Barcelona are being overly stupid. If the rumors around is anything to be believed.
It's not a rumor because I've listened to narratives from Juan Laporta. I've listened to narratives from, you know, the project, the sporting director, and many. I've listened to Xavi himself in a press conference expressing his desire to have Lionel Messi back. So it's not a rumor.
Well,
like Jorge Messi himself has said that his team, together with Messi, are just waiting for that phone call from Barcelona to say, okay, this is what we want from you. But they are yet to receive any official, you know, invitation from Lionel Messi. So it's not necessarily a rumor. But I think that for the lovers of Barcelona, I'm sure they would love to have their legend, their icon back. You actually oppose his coming back, both footballing reasons and for non-footballing reasons. You feel that it doesn't make economic sense, it doesn't make financial sense. I think the other time too, I perfectly agree with you. I feel that, listen, if Barca are going to splash any money in bringing Messi back, pay him, you know, this amount of wages and all of that, you are trying to rebuild. Focus on the rebuilding process. It will take a year or two to get you to European routes because you're looking at this City team. You're looking at the likes of Bayern Munich. You're looking at what possibly Manchester City, Liverpool are likely to do. Manchester United is likely to do. You also want to put yourself in there. And I do not think that you want to literally compete on that elite level by donating out close to about 60% of your wage bill or even 50% of your wage bill to Lionel Messi. Yes, Jordi Alba has spoken about one of the reasons why he did not renew his contract was for the financial reasons to aid the club. Sergio Busquets likewise to aid the club financially because at the back of their mind, they would think they would need all these measures to ensure they bring Lionel Messi back quickly. 60 seconds.
No, but why would they want Lionel Messi back? I don't get it. It's stupid. It's, forgive me, but it's backward. It's paleolithic. And it does not make any footballing reason right. It does not make any economic reason right. I mean, what is all this romance with Lionel Messi? He's gone. Even when they had Lionel Messi, they suffered some of the most humiliating moments in their life.
So you feel they should just let
him go? No, I mean, I don't get this whole charm offensive.
Okay, guys, if you're watching this live on YouTube, this is Sports 101. And this is our Sunday review show. It's dubbed the Sport Roundup. And we started off with the Lionel Messi bit, and it's now become official. Inter Miami have tabled a huge bid, which include deals with Apple, deals with Adidas, even deals with Amazon. Just, you know, these companies are, you know, Amazon, Apple are located in America just to try and, you know, war Lionel Messi. There's also talk of, you know, the Saudis. So one of the reasons why Saudi Arabia is gradually becoming a destination for footballers right now is because they are trying to take a cue from what Qatar did, and they are going to use football to also project the country and to project the image of Saudi Arabia. They believe that Qatar is a success story, and if they also get the likes of Messi, Benzema, all these guys, they could one of these times also host the World Cup. And they are richer than Qatar and all these countries put together. So now,